One benefit of the thunderstorm moving into the city, it's clearing Melbourne's smoke haze, but not before the thick air led to flight cancellations and fresh questions about player welfare at the Australian Open. More from Brett McLeod.
As Melburnians faced another day of trying to avoid the danger from the smoke haze.
Ambulance Victoria have had over 100 respiratory call-outs this morning. That's up about 75%.
Visibility was so poor at Tullamarine that 50 flights were cancelled today. Air services saying it's likely normal flights won't resume for 2 days. Many local pools remain closed, along with the eastern beach in Geelong, but high temperatures still drew bathers.
We're only in early January, and are we supposed to never go to the beach in the summer?
After Melbourne's air quality was yesterday hazardous, much of today's been in the very poor territory, but by this afternoon it was moderate. No comment today from Tennis Australia about images beamed around the world of players too ill to continue their matches.
It was really scary. I couldn't breathe. I didn't know what to do. I had the feeling like I'm going to collapse on the court, and I was really scared.
The Chief Health Officer pressured tennis chiefs to do more.
It was awful to see someone struggling with air quality in a tennis tournament. Tennis Australia needs to work up an air quality policy. Happy to work with them.
We are used to pollution, like we play in China, we play in more polluted countries, but I mean, this is smoke, is something different.
The big slow-moving southerly change pushing into Melbourne this afternoon has helped clear the air, pushing away much of the bushfire smoke, which is good for the city, but not so good for Gippsland.
Unfortunately, the smoke does contract to the east and they'll continue to probably get high concentrated smoke levels in that part of the world.
The smoke from our fires continues to circle the globe. Our air quality is forecast to start worsening again by the weekend. Brett McLeod, Nine News.